if you guys are ready for another whole house clean with me, then you have come to the right place. So let's get ready, let's get motivated, let's get inspired, and let's clean our houses together. I am going to be cleaning my entire house, my kitchen, living room. I have laundry that needs to be done. I'm going to be cleaning bathrooms, bedrooms. I'm going to be doing it all. So let's get ready and clean together. Can you guys see all of that dog hair on our floors? Our dog has been shedding like crazy. And then, you know, not to mention our house was pretty messy. So I wanted to tackle the kitchen and then the living room before I moved on to the upstairs portion of my house. And if you guys are one of my subscribers, I first want to say thank you for subscribing. You guys mean the world to me, and I'm so grateful to have each and every one of you guys here joining me on my channel. And I just hope that you will continue to keep coming back and watching my videos. If you guys are new and you're not a subscriber, I would love to have you guys think about subscribing, hit that red subscribe button, and joining this family of mine. I am a mom of three girls. I have 5-month-old baby twin girls, and I'm just trying to figure out how to get everything done in 24 hours. So if I can bring a smile to your face, help motivate you and inspire you, whether it's through cleaning, mom life, cooking, recipes, vlogs, or whatever it is, even if it's just seeing some cute babies, I would love to have you guys join me on this journey. And if you guys are new and you decide to subscribe, please say hi in the comment section and tell me where you're from. I love getting to know you guys a little bit better. Scary to give in. So to wipe down my kitchen, I am using the Mrs. Meyer's Acorn Spice Multi-Surface Spray. This probably isn't something that's super surprising to you if you have been watching my cleaning videos for a while, and I love this scent. It's perfect for the fall, and since it has that cinnamon smell, it may even be a good transition into Christmas time. I don't know. We'll see. But if you guys want to go check out Grove Collaborative and where I get all of my sprays, my Mrs. Meyer's and Method, I will have a link down below. You can get a free gift set, so go check that out. And then to wipe down my stainless steel appliances, I've been using the Wyman, I have no idea how you pronounce it, the stainless steel wipes. I think they do a really good job, and you do have to wipe with a wipe and then you follow it up with a microfiber cloth and buff it out, but I think this combination does an amazing job on my stainless steel appliances. So I'm curious, now that it's September and that means fall will be here very soon, do you guys like the pumpkin spice lattes? I know they're really popular and I personally am not a huge fan. I drink my coffee black, which I know is pretty boring, but let me know in the comment section if you guys like pumpkin spice lattes or how do you like your coffee in the fall? I'm just curious because I know so many people like their coffee different ways and sometimes people switch it up with the seasons. So let me know down below how you drink your coffee in the fall and if you like the pumpkin spice lattes. So this was a little cleaning hack I recently shared in another video, but I wrapped a Lysol wipe or you can use a wet paper towel around a butter knife, and it allowed me to get in that small space between the countertop and the stove. If you guys are curious what I'm using in this spray bottle, it's a multi-surface / disinfecting spray that I mix up myself, and I really like using it all over. It is just 1/4 of a cup of rubbing alcohol, a teaspoon of dish soap, and 3 cups of water. And I just love it because it can shine my sink after I'm done scrubbing it, shine up my glass top stove, and I can also use it on my granite countertops. It's safe to use, and it also functions as a disinfectant because you have that alcohol in it. It's also super cheap. I know this is so crazy, but I love scrubbing my sink. I personally find it so therapeutic, and I just love when my sink is shiny. If you guys are enjoying this video, please go ahead and give it a thumbs up. I have plenty of more videos just like this planned here on my channel. I've been enjoying this kind of cleaning, this 2-day cleaning sessions, because I don't have a lot of time right now to devote to cleaning for hours and hours on end. And sometimes our nights, you know, I can pick up things here and there, but to really devote the time to cleaning, I've been enjoying, you know, spending a couple hours one day and then a couple hours the next day. And by breaking it up, it allows me to get it all done as well as still spend time with my family. So something I've been doing lately in my cleaning videos is sharing a cleaning tip, a cleaning hack, something that can make your life easier when you're cleaning. And I want to create a cleaning community. So for as many videos as I can, I'm going to pick a cleaning hack submitted by one of you, feature it on my video at the end so you guys can all learn from it. So if you guys have any cleaning hacks or tips that you want to share, please, please let me know in the comment section, and hopefully we can all help each other. And then it was time to move on to my living room and pick everything up there, as well as dust and vacuum. And something I really wanted to make for sure I did was vacuum my couches. That's something that I haven't done as often as I should. So I wanted to make for sure I crossed that chore off of my list tonight. Sweet, and you care about my night. But I'm sobering up in this moment's past. And if you guys are curious, I was just using microfiber cloths to wipe everything down in my house. It was so crazy because as I was cleaning, it was starting to get darker, and it's starting to get darker earlier now where I live, and it makes it feel so much later than what it really was. And I know this is going to sound super weird. I know I'm probably in the minority, but I kind of like it when it gets darker a little bit earlier. There's something cozy about it, and maybe it's just because we're getting ready to get into the fall season, and it's just, I don't know, there's something about the weather cooling down and it getting darker. There's something cozy about it that I kind of like.
Seem too nice to be alone, so lonely. I see you going through some things and I just wanna help. I don't know how to make it clearer.
So you guys have been wanting to see the before and the after of my vacuum when I'm done vacuuming, so there you go. There was not a before, but I'm showing you the after, but it was completely empty before I started vacuuming.
Just like I'm waiting for something better.
So then the next morning I woke up, and once my husband and I fed the girls, I got to cleaning. And it was a Saturday morning, and we are big Ohio State college football fans, so the game was going to be on at noon. So I wanted to get up, get moving, and get all of my cleaning done before the game started. And I also wanted to get a run in. I love working out and staying fit, so I was kind of doing my own version of speed cleaning, because I knew that if I didn't get my cleaning done, I wasn't going to get my run in. So Mike and I just got up, fed the girls, and then once they were down for their nap, I got to cleaning. And I started out in our master bedroom just by picking things up, making the bed, dusting. And when I was dusting, I was using an e-cloth, and I've been using them recently here on my channel. It's a cloth. It's a microfiber cloth that you don't need to use any cleaner with. And so I was using that to dust everything. And a lot of people were asking me questions because they didn't understand how the e-cloth worked. You know, how does the cloth clean if you're not using any cleaner? And I think that's a very valid question. So you can go and check out their website. And I do want to mention that this isn't sponsored or anything, but they're great because you don't have to use any chemicals while you're cleaning. And the results have shown in a laboratory that has been accredited that the e-cloths and water remove 99% of bacteria and mold, and all of that gets locked away in the cloth's fibers where it stays until the cloths are rinsed. So it's a really good special microfiber towel that cleans your house without using any cleaner. So if you guys want to know more, if you want more information, you can go check them out. There is a link in the video's description. So I was kind of hopping around this morning, cleaning room to room, and I needed Avery's help for her room since she had made a lot of the mess that was in there, or really all of the mess, I guess, that was in there. So we went in and got started on her room. And did you guys see that little photo shoot we had before we got started? She has this little play camera, and she told me to pose, and she specifically asked me to pose with my two fingers up, showing a peace sign, and I have no idea where she got that from and how she, or why she wanted me to pose like that, but she did.
I don't even care to die. I see you in a while, 'cause this time I will choose you, yeah. I'll choose. You know exactly how they look like this. Holding in a bag full of goods and needs. I need a night like this. Knowing it's a risk, 'cause you're using it. You got all.
So I don't know if you guys noticed, but I have a nice little glow while I'm cleaning. Well, if you did notice it, that means my self-tanner did a really good job. I've been using the Loving Tan self-tanner. I love this stuff. I'll link it down below if you guys want to check it out. It lets me have a nice tan without me having to sit outside in the sun, because obviously I don't have time for that. And I also know that it's not the healthiest. So it's just nice for me to be able to use a self tanner that is good, that doesn't look orange on me. And I've been using it for pretty much the whole summer and I love it. So if you guys want to check it out, it's down below. After Avery's bedroom, I then moved on to cleaning her bathroom. And I guess now it's not just Avery's bathroom, it's also Addison and Emery's bathroom, but it's mainly Avery's because she's the one with all of the stuff in there. And I pretty much just wanted to pick things up and wipe things down. And I just grabbed these Lysol Kitchen Pro antibacterial wipes to quickly wipe everything down in there. And again, I was kind of speed cleaning and just trying to get everything done as quickly as possible. And these Lysol Kitchen Pro wipes do a really good job. They were new, and I've never tried them before. And I think I like them better than just the regular Lysol wipes. I think they did a pretty good job wiping everything up. I was kind of cleaning out of order today, so I went back through our bedroom and then started to clean our master bathroom. And Avery wanted to show off her sunglasses and her hat and say hi to you guys. So I was using the glass and polishing e-cloth to clean my mirrors. It's kind of the same concept. You just get the rag wet and it cleans my mirrors and my windows, and it does a really good job. Don't forget to stick around for the cleaning hack that I'm going to share with you at the end of the video. This hack will save you money and make sure your house stays cleaner as well as your dishes. After I was done with the master bathroom, I moved on to the hallway, and I just wanted to wipe down this ledge area and then vacuum. We end up using this ledge for kind of a catch-all for everything upstairs, which is nice, but I don't really think it gets wiped down as often as it should, so I wanted to go ahead and do that. My laundry was almost done in the dryer, and I wanted to pop in really quickly and go and vacuum Addison and Emery's room. They had woken up from their nap, and they were downstairs hanging with their dad, but I wanted to vacuum in there before I folded the laundry, and this is what was in the vacuum after I vacuumed our entire upstairs. So I wasn't able to finish folding as soon as I got done vacuuming the girls' room. There was just other things that pulled my attention away. So this was later in the day after I had ran, I showered, we watched the football game, but I wanted to make for sure I was able to get this done so the laundry wasn't just sitting there. So I folded, and here in a minute, we're gonna get to that cleaning hack. So definitely stick around for that. But I'm gonna go ahead and say goodbye to you guys here before we go there. And thank you guys so much for sticking around this entire video. You guys are amazing, and I love each and every one of you guys. Don't forget to subscribe, give me a thumbs up, and now let's get to that hack. Know you much better. This hack is from GreenThumb22. So we all have sponges in our kitchen, right? A common question I get asked is how often I switch them out. And I probably buy new ones about once a month, maybe a little bit more. But in between buying new sponges, I wash my sponges in the dishwasher. So every couple of days, I will make for sure that there's no soap or anything in the sponge, and then I put them in the dishwasher and run it on a really hot cycle. So my sponges get washed, disinfected, so they are nice and clean when we go to wash our dishes the next time. So there you guys go, a way to prolong the life of your sponges, help you save money, and get your dishes cleaner. Yeah,